everyone. Welcome back to WayKen Rapid Manufacturers channel. This is TJ here. This part in my hand is a semi-finished plastic part. And this is what it will look like when it is finished. To make things easier to understand, let's call this side A and this side B. As you can see in the 3D and 2D joints, the wall of side A is only 0.5 millimeters thick. And there is a slot between side A and side B that is 12 millimeters deep and 6 millimeters wide. On side A, there are some tap holes with positional accuracy and perpendicular requirements. This is a bit tricky. Without following specific program steps with right method and tools, it is very easy to mess up with tolerance requirements. First, we need a 3+2 or 5-axis CNC machine that will allow us to machine side A and the slot in the same clamp set. Make sure you leave enough meat between the slot and the base. It is very important to get enough support from the base during the second round of clamping. Start from side A. It will be much easier to meet the positional accuracy and the perpendicular requirements of the tap hole when machining on a solid piece of material. Okay. Without removing the part from the machining base, the 3+2 machine helps us turn the part to the side and cut the slot with the right tolerance. And now we have a semi-finished part, as you can see in my hand. Before putting this part on the 3-axis CNC machine for final machining, it is extremely important to fill and tighten the slot with some small boards. These boards will provide support against the pressure of the machine tool as it cuts from the side B. While cutting side B, as the meat is cut away, the strands from the surrounding material, which helps hold side A and side B together, is getting weaker and weaker. So we should leave a few bones like these between side A and side B during machining to ensure tolerance. Otherwise, the external tension from the board, which was supposed to give support against the cutting force, will push side B away and affect the tolerance. And we can always manually remove these bones later. That's all for today. Thank you again for joining us for this video, and we hope you have learned something today. If you like this video, please subscribe and give us a like. See you next time. Bye-bye.